Welcome back to the academy, guys. Let's see the PENG block. It is otherwise called as pericapsular nerve group block. This is a recently introduced block. It was introduced back in 2018, basically introduced as a motor sparing alternative for analgesia after total hip replacement or any proximal hip procedures. If we see the options for postoperative analgesia for total hip replacement and proximal hip procedures, we basically have two options. First option being intravenous analgesics including opioids, and second options obviously the regional blocks. In regional blocks itself, we have lot of blocks starting from the basic blocks like femoral nerve block, facioiliacal block, suprainguinal or infrainguinal block, epidural analgesia, and going up to the complex blocks like lumbar paravertebral block, QL blocks, erector spinae block, etc. So this is the order of blocks which we say according to difficulty in performing the blocks. I have made videos on facioiliacal block and erector spinae block. I will give the link in the description. You can go and check in the description for watching the video and getting a refreshed idea about these blocks. Why PENG block? As I said, for postoperative analgesia, for total hip replacement and other proximal hip procedures, we have two options. First option being intravenous analgesics, and as you know, they are not providing adequate analgesia and they are associated with complications, especially opioids, especially in the geriatric populations who are the major target population who ends up with the proximal hip related pathologies. Then in comparison to other blocks, why we prefer PENG block? We have three main reasons why PENG block is preferred. First reason, for classic simple blocks like femoral nerve block and infrainguinal facioiliacal block, these are easy blocks to perform, but most of the time they does not provide adequate analgesia because of few anatomical reasons which we will discuss later. Secondly, for complex blocks like erector spinae block at the lumbar level, quadratus lumborum block or lumbar paravertebral blocks, advantage is these provide adequate analgesia, but the problem is, first is they are difficult to perform, second one, they are associated with motor weakness of the quadriceps muscles and they hinder with the postoperative ambulation of the patient. So three major reasons are either they are difficult to perform, or they are associated with motor weakness, or they does not provide adequate analgesia. So I have said that for classic blocks like femoral nerve block and classic infrainguinal facioiliacal block, there is lack of adequate analgesia because of some anatomical reasons. For this, we have to see the innervation of the hip. If you see innervation of hip, the most important thing we have to see is the innervation of the hip capsule itself, because that is the most important cause of pain in hip related pathologies. Anatomically, the hip capsule is divided into two parts. We have an anterior hip capsule and a posterior part. The anterior part, which is the nociceptive component, that is the cause of pain in hip related pathologies. It is supplied by the articular branches from femoral nerve, obturator nerve and the accessory obturator nerve. Accessory obturator nerve is seen only in 10 to 30% of population, but if it is present, it will contribute to pain. If you see the posterior part of the hip capsule, this part is mainly mechanoreceptors and does not contribute much to nociception. So it is the anterior part of the hip capsule and the nerve supplying the anterior part which we have to block to get adequate analgesia for any hip related procedures. So coming to the articular branches from these three major nerves, what we have to know is that these three articular branches leave the major nerves at a proximal level, that is in the suprainguinal level they leave the major nerves. So if you are giving a classic femoral nerve block or a classic infrainguinal block, they are very distal, and if you give the block, it will not block the articular branches and you will not get adequate analgesia. The problem with blocks involving the proximal part, that is where the articular branches are with the major nerves, you get adequate analgesia, but along with the articular branches, you are going to block the major nerves as well and you end up with the femoral nerve block and associated quadriceps weakness and further hindering of the postoperative ambulation of the patient. So that's why the PENG block comes into importance, because it is exactly where you are going to block the articular branches of the femoral nerve, obturator nerve and the accessory obturator nerve without much involvement of the major nerves itself. So you escape from the complications like postoperative motor weakness and difficulty in ambulation of the patient, and at the same time you get best and adequate analgesia for hip related procedures. So let's see the anatomy which we have to know in relation to giving the PENG block. So this is our hip. So there are few bony landmarks which we have to know, because they will come significant when you are seeing the sono anatomy related to PENG block. So this bony landmark, as you all know, is the anterior superior iliac spine. Medially and inferiorly we have the anterior inferior iliac spine, and further medially what you are seeing is the superior pubic ramus, and this part of the superior pubic ramus is called as the iliopectineal eminence. Okay, these are the major four bony landmarks. Few of these bony landmarks we have already seen when giving the supra-inguinal fasciliacal block. As I've said, I have given a link in the description, you can go and watch. Watching the supra-inguinal fasciliacal block will give you a better idea about PENG block also, because initial scanning with the ultrasound is almost same for both the blocks. So go and watch the video and come back, okay? So other than the bony landmarks which you have to see, two major muscles which you have to see is the iliacus muscle, seen on the lateral side, and on the medial side this muscle is called as the psoas major muscle. And psoas major muscle, in close attachment to the superior pubic ramus iliopectineal eminence, we have the psoas tendon. And more medially, the muscle which you are seeing is the pectineus muscle, which is not much of significance. So two important muscles which you have to know is the iliacus and the psoas major muscle with the psoas tendon. So our target area where you are going to see these articular branches of the femoral nerve, obturator nerve and the accessory obturator nerve is in between the psoas tendon and the iliopectineal eminence. So our target area for depositing the local anesthetic is also in the same plane. So it is in this plane between the muscle and the bone where you are going to see the articular branches, and the major nerves are far away from this target area. On the superior medial side of the muscles which you have seen, we can see the femoral nerve, the femoral artery and femoral vein. This is also very important, especially if you are giving a landmark or nerve stimulator guided technique, because you have to avoid these structures when you are inserting the needle. So from this picture itself, you can clearly see that the major nerve, the femoral nerve, is far away from our target site, and it is very highly unlikely for you to block the femoral nerve if you are giving a PENG block, and that is why you get saved from the postoperative motor weakness associated with the femoral nerve block, that is the blocking of the quadratus femoris muscle supply. Actually, initially there was another block which was demonstrated called as blocking the articular branch of the femoral nerve block. So this block was published in this article, you can go and check it out there. So actually in this article we are only blocking the articular branch of the femoral nerve. So in the PENG block, it is actually considered as a supra-inguinal alternative for this same block, with an added advantage of blocking the articular branches of the accessory obturator and the obturator nerve. So you can give articular branch of femoral nerve block alone, but it will not give you adequate analgesia because you are missing the obturator and accessory obturator nerve. That's why they have come up with a PENG block. And that is the same reason why this block, the articular branch of femoral nerve block, did not get much of a popularity, because they are obviously sparing the other two nerves and you will not get adequate analgesia. So if you see the areas which is supplied by the PENG block, that is the osteotome coverage involves this area which is highlighted here. So that is why clearly you can see how PENG block is useful in indications like acetabulum fracture, for proximal femur fractures including the fracture neck of femur, intertrochanteric fracture and the proximal femur shaft fractures. So these are the indications for giving the PENG block, which you clearly get to know when you see the osteotome supply. So let's see the contraindications for giving PENG block. As such, there is no specific contraindications, only general contraindications like patient refusal, the patient has got allergy to local anesthetic, or if there is local infection, or as per ASTRA guidelines, if the patient's international normalized ratio, or otherwise called as INR, is more than 1.5, these are the contraindications for giving the PENG block. There is no specific contraindication for giving PENG block. So that completes the part 1 of the video. In this, we have discussed in detail about the analgesic options for total hip replacement and other proximal hip pathologies. And we have seen in detail why other blocks are not effective in providing adequate analgesia, and what other advantage we get if we give PENG block, and few indications and contraindications for giving PENG block. So in the next video, I will be coming up with the sono anatomy, how to scan and how to give the block, and what complications you have to expect when you are giving the PENG block. So that completes the video. Until we see next time, thank you.